إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله، وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وبعد، from the virtue of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the believers and upon the mu'mineen is that Allah Azza wa Jal blesses the believers with mawasim. Allah Azza wa Jal blesses the believers with periods, mawasim of khair, periods that are filled with good for the believer if they capitalize upon those periods. And indeed, ayyuhal ikhwa, in a few days we will have upon us one of the greatest periods from the periods of khair throughout the year, and that is the Ashar of Dhul Hijjah, the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us, ikhwan, within these 10 days with a great amount of khair, abundant khair, that we will mention something from that. And that which the believer should do is that he, when these periods come about, that he prepares for them, that he prepares himself for those days in order to capitalize upon them in the best and most apt way. From the first of the ways that the servant and the abd prepares himself, as is the case with his life throughout his year and in all of his days, by turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in tawbah. Constantly, the servant is one that returns to Allah Azza wa Jal, and Allah Azza wa Jal loves that from his abd. He loves that the servant constantly returns. Not that he's an individual that is arrogant and believes that he is upon all khair and no need for him to repent or make tawbah. That he fulfills and carries out everything that is upon him, and that he has no shortcomings and no deficiencies, much less sin. That, ayyuhal ikhwa, is without doubt from the tricks of shaitan. And there is no one, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned, kullu bani Adam khatta, all of the children of Adam commit sins. And the best of those who commit sins are those who turn in tawbah and repentance. And so, as is the case throughout the year, as this period approaches, the servant, he turns to Allah Azza wa Jal, carrying out the statement of Allah Azza wa Jal, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Turn to repentance, or turn in repentance to Allah Azza wa Jal, أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, O believers, each and every one of you, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, that perchance you may receive success. And so we understand from that, that in tawbah is the success and the falah of the servant. So he makes tawbah. He turns to Allah Azza wa Jal, knowing that Allah Azza wa Jal loves that. And so he begins his preparation well. Similarly, from the affairs that he prepares with, is that he prepares himself psychologically with jazm and with firm resolve and azam. Firm resolve that he's going to carry out and fulfill and act upon the best of that which he knows within these days. That he's going to strive his utmost to capitalize from this period of khair that is coming upon him. And so he prepares himself psychologically for that which is about to come from the period. Likewise, he prepares himself with al-bu'd and al-ma'asi. He prepares himself by distancing himself from sin, knowing that just as the month of Ramadan, it is a period of khair and a period wherein one capitalizes and distances himself from sin, likewise these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, the believer, he prepares himself with al-bu'd and al-ma'asi, distances himself from sin, as he should be striving to do throughout the year. And then he acquaints himself with the virtues of that which is about to come. Thus, from the virtues, ayyuhal ikhwa, of this blessed month, or these 10 days at least, of this blessed month, first and foremost, is that Allah Azza wa Jal swears by them. And Allah Azza wa Jal swears by that which he sees and that which Allah Azza wa Jal wishes from his makhluqat and from his creation. As far as the believer, then he only swears by Allah. He does not swear on his mother's life, neither on his father's grave. All of that enters into the affairs of shirk. But he swears by Allah Azza wa Jal alone. But Allah Azza wa Jal swears by whatever he wills from his creation. And know that our scholars have mentioned that when Allah Azza wa Jal swears by a thing, it indicates the great station of that thing. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he swears, as it occurs in the beginnings of Surah Al-Fajr, Wal-Fajr Walayalin Ashar. He swears by the dawn, by Fajr, and then he follows that by swearing by the Layalin Ashar, swearing by the 10 nights. And our scholars mentioned that there is a reference to the days of Dhul Hijjah, the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And Ibn Kathir rahimahullah ta'ala, after mentioning that this is one of the positions of the people of knowledge, he mentions وَهُوَ الصَّحِيحِ, and this is what is correct. Yani from the statements concerning what is intended by those Layalin Ashar, by those 10 nights. And that is, and has in it an indication of the fact that the days and the nights of Dhul Hijjah, of the 10 of Dhul Hijjah, are virtuous. Though the scholars differ concerning which of the two is best. Is it the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah and the last 10 nights of Ramadan? They differ. They mention, as it relates to the nights, then if one were to compare the first 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah with the last 10 nights of Ramadan, then the last 10 nights of Ramadan are more virtuous. But when looking and comparing the days in totality as wholes, then there is no doubt that the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah are more virtuous than the last 10 of Ramadan. And thus there is no doubt that they are the 10 most virtuous days of the year. These Layal al-Ashar that will be upon us in a few days. Similarly, that which indicates the virtue of these days is that these are days wherein Allah Azza wa Jal commands with the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, and with carrying out that which pleases Him. As Allah Azza wa Jal mentions concerning the believers, that they mention Allah and they mention the name of Allah fi ayyamin ma'lumat. They mention the name of Allah in known days. And again, the ulama and the scholars of tafsir mentioned that this is a reference to the days, or the ashr of ten, the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Similarly, from its virtue is that the Prophet ﷺ indicated that these are the best days of the dunya. Upon the authority of Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhu, he mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ, he said, فَضْلُ أَيَّامِ الدُّنْيَا أَيَّامِ الْعَشَرِ. And في الرواية أفضل أيام الدنيا أيام العشر. That the best of the days of the dunya are the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And that then is clear. He mentions and continues, قيل ولا مثلهن في سبيل الله قال ولا مثلهن في سبيل الله. And someone said, and so there are no days that are better than them, not even in the way of Allah. The days that one spends fighting in the way of Allah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he responded, not even the days that are spent fighting in the way of Allah. He mentions, إِلَّا رَجُلٌ, except for a man, that ends with his face in the sand, in the dirt. Yani, except for a man whose life is taken, في سبيل الله. Yani, he's martyred, في سبيل الله. Other than that, then the days that one spends in the way of Allah, fighting في سبيل الله, are not better than these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And our scholars, they mention likewise that the ahadith that indicate the virtue of performing the righteous actions in these days are greater than performing any righteous action outside of these days, and we'll mention the hadith. Similarly, from the virtue of Dhul Hijjah, these 10 days, is within them is the day of Arafah, Yawm Arafah. And it is Yawm al-Hajj al-Akbar with a group of the people of Tafsir and the scholars of Tafsir. It is the great day of Hajj, the day of Arafah. Similarly, from its virtue and its great noble characteristics, is within them is Yawm al-Nahar. Within them is the day of Nahar, or the day of slaughtering, where the Hujjaj carry out those great actions, from the shaving of the head, from the slaughtering of their sacrificial lambs and their animals, from the Tawaf al-Ifada and the Sa'i, all of these things, and the stoning of the Jamarat, all of these great things that are taking place, or that take place during Hajj, they take place within these days. And from their virtues, the people of knowledge, they mention, is that we have within them Ijtima'u Ummuhatil A'mal. Within them we have the coming together of the greatest and the mother of all actions. Salah, Zakah, Siyam, Hajj, all of the great actions, they come together in these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And thus there are no days that are more virtuous than them ala al-itlaq. No days that are more virtuous than them at all. And that no doubt requires, ikhwan, that we prepare for them and that we capitalize from them. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Bismillah walhamdulillah. Wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man wala wa ba'd. from that which will indicate the virtue, ikhwan, of these ayyam and these days, is that which is related to the actions that are performed within them. Indeed, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he informed us, as occurs in the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma. He mentions, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيها أحب إلى الله من هذه الأيام, يعني أيام العشر. قالوا يا رسول الله ولا جهاد في سبيل الله؟ قال ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله ثم لم يرجع من ذلك بشيء. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said that there is no day, or there are no days, that righteous actions are more virtuous within them than the, and more beloved to Allah azza wa jal, than the days of Dhul Hijjah, yani the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. The companions, they said, not even jihad fi sabilillah. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he responded, not even jihad fi sabilillah, except for a man that leaves out with his wealth and with his self, with his person, and returns with nothing. That is, his, he spends his wealth fi sabilillah, and he is martyred fi sabilillah. No one, ikhwan, other than this individual. And the scholars, they mention, and it is something for us to reflect upon, and that is the meaning of this statement, there are no days wherein actions are better than these days. That is, that the righteous actions that one performs within these days, regardless of how small those righteous actions are, they are better than the greatest of the righteous actions that are performed outside of these days. So when one performs a small action, or that which is considered a small action, from the acts of khair and good, it is better and more virtuous than to perform the greatest actions outside of Dhul Hijjah. The righteous actions are multiplied during this period, even the small ones. And they are considered greater than great actions outside of this period of the days of Dhul Hijjah. Khair wa baraka, virtue that Allah Azza wa Jal gives to the believers, but few are there that capitalize. The days come along, we know that it is this beautiful, virtuous period. We mention and we hear speeches and sermons concerning them, but we rarely capitalize. Siyam and salah and sadaqah and khair that should be done within these days, we rarely capitalize. And before we know it, it is Eid. And before we know it, the 10 days are over. So, ikhwan, capitalize upon these days. As far as that which is related to the types of actions that one may perform, then of course, ikhwan, this period is a period of the performance of that great sha'ira from the sha'air of the deen, al-hajj. Allah Azza wa Jal mentions, al-hajj ashhurun ma'lumat, that the hajj is performed in a number of known months. And the greatest, of course, ikhwan, days from the days of hajj are the days within the action, or within which the actions of hajj are performed, starting from the 8th of Dhul Hijjah and ending in or upon the 13th of Dhul Hijjah. These ayyam, days wherein one of the greatest pillars from the pillars of Islam is performed and carried out. Those of you who are able to perform the Hajj, then if he is able and has the ability and has not performed Hajj, then he must do so. It is binding upon him if he has the ability. And that ability is financial and physical. If he has the financial ability and the physical ability, then Hajj is wajib upon him. And of course, you are acquainted with the hadith, Al-umratu ila al-umra kafaratun lima baynahun. Wa fi riwayah, لما بينهما، والحج المبرور ليس له جزاء إلا الجنة. عمرة، one عمرة to another عمرة is an expiation for that which occurs between them from sin. While the Hajj al-Mabroor, the accepted Hajj, the one that is performed correctly, has no reward other than Jannah. Or like the statement of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as occurs in the hadith of Ibn Abbas, من حج ولم يرفث ولم يفسق رجع كيوم ولدته أمه. The one who makes Hajj and doesn't يرفث, that is, he doesn't address his spouse concerning relations and speak of those types of affairs. وَلَمْ يَفْسُقْ, neither does he commit sins. رَجَعَ كَيَوْمِ وَلَدَتْهُ أُمُّهُ, then he returns as the day his mother gave birth to him. Pure, clean, a fresh slate, purified from sin. Similarly, from that which is prescribed, ikhwan, within these days is the fasting, particularly the fast of the day of Arafah. Fasting upon the day of Arafah. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentions, يُكَفِّرُ السَّنَةِ الْمَاضِيَةِ وَالْبَاقِيَةِ, that it expiates the previous year's sin and the future year's sin. One day's fast. And so we have fasting prescribed within these days. Likewise, ayyuhal ikhwa, it goes without saying that one increases in the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal, as it is prescribed to perform the takbirat within the days of Eid during this period, yani Eid al-Adha. The takbirat, and those who perform Hajj will be performing the talbiyah throughout their Hajj, up until the period wherein the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he ceased making the talbiyah. But for a number of days, they will be making talbiyah and extolling the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so it is a day, or these are days of dhikr and the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. Similarly, these are days of sadaqah. For indeed Allah Azza wa Jal has commanded us with that. Since Allah Azza wa Jal commands us, ayyuhal ikhwa, with sadaqah throughout the Quran, that you should anfaqu mimma razaqnakum, spend from that which we have given you, before a day comes that there will be no trade, neither will friendships benefit anyone, neither would any intercession benefit anyone. وَالْكَافِرُونَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. These days, ayyuhal ikhwa, are the best days for the giving of sadaqah, the giving of virtue, due to the multiplication of the reward for those actions during these days. And since that is the case, then ayyuhal ikhwa, we encourage the brothers and we encourage the sisters with capitalizing upon this period. Know that it will be upon us in just a few days, and it will pass in that which will feel like it was just a few days. When it comes upon us, ikhwan, let us be ready for its coming. In a similar manner in which we prepare for Ramadan, let us prepare for this period. Let us prepare, ayyuhal ikhwa, for this period wherein sins are forgiven. These great sha'air of the deen are performed. Allah Azza wa Jal overlooks his servants and rewards and multiplies their actions. The one who is astute and the one who is intelligent and smart, the one who is upon guidance and khair, then he'll capitalize from this. He doesn't know, it may well be the last 10 that he sees. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله